Control accounts. The word control in accounting is total. So when you make the control accounts, we have to take the values in total. That is what you call the control accounts. So here, first of all, we have to identify this ledger. Ledger can be divided into two, general ledger and subsidiary ledger. Ledger can be divided into two, general ledger and subsidiary ledger. Subsidiary ledger, we are dividing again into two, debtors ledger and creditors ledger. Now I'll explain to you what you mean by debtors ledger and creditors ledger. In this debtors ledger, we record all the individual debtor accounts. For example, in your question, there are three debtors called A, B, C. Individual accounts of A, B, C, we have to draw under the heading called debtors ledger. So same here, in the creditors ledger, we open up individual creditor account. For example, if you have three creditors called XYZ, you had to open up 3T accounts under the heading called creditors ledger. So remember, in the debtors ledger, we open all the individual debtors account. In the creditors ledger, we open individual creditor accounts. When it comes to a general ledger, we have to open all the accounts, including control account, that is debtors control and creditors control. So here, under the heading called general ledger, we had to open all the T accounts other than individual debtors and creditors accounts. So when you make accounts under the heading called general ledger, we have to make debtors control and creditors control account. So the individual amounts you have entered under the debtors ledger, the total amount you are going to take to the control account. So here, this question, I have taken it from the past paper. The following information relates to Varuna and Company for the month of April 2020. Credit purchases details, supplier's name, Susit Lasith, balance as at 1/4. Credit purchases, purchase return, amount paid in April, and discount received. Now in here, the requirement they ask us to prepare accounts in the general ledger and accounts in the creditors ledger and debtors ledger. So in the general ledger, we have to open all accounts including control. Whereas in the creditors ledger, we are opening Susit and Lasit accounts. In the debtors ledger, we open Kapila and Amila's account. So if we go to individual accounts first, here's the heading debtors ledger. Under that, I open two accounts, Kapila and Amila. The given information, we have to record it. Kapila opening balance 12,000. Amila 28,000. Kapila BF to the debit 12,000 because they are debtors. Amila debit 28,000. Credit sales. The double entry is sales credit, debtors debit. Sales credit, debtors debit. In the individual account, we are writing sales 10,000, sales 16,000. Sales return, double entry is sales return account, debit, debtors credit. So we are writing sales return 2,000 and 1,000 here. Then in the question, they have given cash received from Kapila and Amila, cash debit, individual account credit. Discount allowed debit, individual account credit, 415 and 900. So when you balance this Kapila's account, you can get a BF of 4,550. In Amila's account, you will get a balance of 12,100. Now, when it comes to general ledger, in the general ledger, we are opening an account called debtors control, but here we enter the total amount. So either this entry, you can get it from the question itself. The total BF amount of is 40,000. That is what we have to put it onto the debit side. The double entry is there. So whenever you think of the double entry, you are doing the double entry in the general ledger. Remember that. So here, debtors control account, 40,000 is a BF. When you're looking at the debtors ledger, even you can get the same amount. Opening balance is 12 and 28. Addition is 40 to the same side, because debtor is an asset. Then the total sales amount, 26,000. When you think of the double entry is debtors control debit, sales account credit. Debtors control debit, sales account credit as debtors control. So always remember, in the general ledger only we have the double entry. Sales return, the total amount is 3,000. Sales return account debit, debtor control credit, 3,000. Sales return debit. Amount received, the total amount you receive from debtors, 45,000. Cash debit, debtors control credit. Cash credit, debtors control credit. Discount allowed double entry, discount allowed debit, debtors control credit, altogether 1,350. So debtors control credit and discount allowed debit. Now, when you prepare debtors control account under the heading general ledger, the amount that you are getting as a carried down brought forward, it should be equal with the debtors ledger balance. Now, under the heading called debtors ledger, we are opening a debtors list. Kapila 4,550, Amila 12,100. When you added up these two, you got 16,650. So if you have done the debtors control also the same way, that balance should be 16,650. So if you have done a question properly, your debtors list balance will equal to the control account balance. Same here for the creditors. Two creditors are there, Susit and Lasit. These individual values you can put it into each and every person's account, and the total amount you have to put it into the control account. So here in the creditors ledger, BF 18,000 to the credit Susit, Lasit 15,000, credit purchases 25,000, Lasit, Susit 20,000. Purchase return to the debit side, 2,000 in Lasit account. Cash 25,000, discount received 250. When you balance these two accounts, ultimately we are making a list, creditors list. Susit 4,700, Lasit 12,750. Addition is 17,450. In the general ledger, we have to open up a creditors control account. So that is why I said the word control is total. So here we are entering in total. BF to the credit 33,000, 18 plus 15, 33,000. Credit purchases, the full amount is 45,000. Purchases, 45. Purchase return addition, 5,000. Cash, 55,000. Discount received, 550. Now here I have put the double entries even. Creditor control, credit 45,000. Purchasers account, debit 45,000. Creditor control, debit 5,000 as purchase return. Purchase return account, credit 5,000 as creditors control. Discount received, creditor control, debit 550. Discount received account, credit 550. Remember in here, I didn't open up a cash control account. So if you open up a cash control, this 45,000, you have to put it onto the debit side as debtors control. This 55,000, you have to put it onto the credit side as creditors control. So here, when you balance a creditors control, your closing balance is 17,450. So when you go to your creditors ledger, that amount you have to get it for the addition of list. So in this question, creditors list balance is equal to your creditor control account balance, whereas debtors list balance equal to debtors control account balance. So always remember, in the general ledger only you have the double entry. By looking at the general ledger, you can prepare the trial balance. But when you're looking at the debtors ledger, only one entry is there. Only one entry is there, so you can't open up any trial balance from this one. So by looking at the general ledger only, we can open up a trial balance. Now again, this is a past paper question. The following information is extracted from Heshan's business for the month of Jan 2020. Opening balances are given for Maya, Gihan and Sunil. The total of sales journal for each and every person, 30,000, 18, 22 and 20. And they have given the receipts journal to you. Now here, if you open up a debtor's ledger, there are four accounts: Maya, Gihan, Suren, and Sunil. So Maya's opening balance is 10,000. In the sales journal, the credit sales amount is 30. So Maya debit 30,000 as sales. When you're looking at the receipt journal, here there's a discount of 2,000 and amount you receive from Maya 20,000. So when you think of the double entry, discount allowed debit, debtor credit. So you are putting onto the Maya's account discount allowed 2,000 and cash 20,000. Then when you balance, you get a carried down and brought forward of 18,000. Just like the same way we have to open Gihan, Suren, Sunil and balance all the accounts and make a list. When you make this list, again, you get a double line amount, 60,000. This is the total of all these four debtor balance. So if you go to your general ledger, we have to open up a debtors control and other ledger accounts. So when you add it up, 10,000, 8,000 and 5,000, this is your opening balance. So that amount, we have to put it into your debtors control as BF, 23,000. the total of the sales journal, addition of all these four, think of the double entry. Sales account credit, debtors control debit. Sales account credit 90,000, debtors control debit 90,000. The total amount of discount 6,000. When you think of the double entry, discount allowed debit 6,000, debtors control credit 6,000. Debtors control credit 6,000. This is the total of cash sales. The double entry is cash control debit 34,000 as sales, sales account credit 34,000 as cash. The total amount you receive from debtors 47,000. Cash control debit 47,000 as debtors control. Debtors control credit 47,000 as cash control. Under income, you got rent. So cash debit, rent account credit. Cash control debit 6,000 and rent account credit 6,000. So when you balance the debtors control account, you get a carried down and brought forward of 60,000. If you go to the debtors list, that addition of all debtor balances, it will be 60,000. Now, in this question, you all have to make only the debtors control account and the creditors control account. Opening balances are given. Debtors control, there's a debit balance, and creditor control, the balance is onto the credit side. And they have given transactions. So credit purchases, you have to put it into the creditors control. Credit sales to the debtors control. Cash received from debtors, again, debtors control, it's cash debit, debtor control, credit. Opening balances, the total sales and cash. Creditors BF, purchases 110,000. Cash paid to creditors, cash credit, creditors control debit. Sales return, double entry is sales return account debit, debtors control credit. Then you get the purchase return, creditor control debit, 2,000 as purchase return. Bad debts account debit, debtor control credit. Discount allowed account debit, debtor account credit. Discount received, creditor control debit, and discount received account credit. Cash refunded to debtors. So when you refund some amount of money to debtors, cash credit, debtors control debit. Debtors control debit. Now here, when it comes to control account, you will get an entry called set off entry, or we call it as contra entry. So the meaning of set off is the same person acts as a debtor as well as a creditor. So debtor is a person, he has to pay money to the business. Creditor is a person, business owes money to an outsider. So what will happen if the same person acts as a debtor as well as a creditor? You can, as a business, you can set off some amount of money. That's called the set off entry. So So for example, there is a debtor, he has to pay us 10,000, but in return, he's the same person, we have bought some stock on credit, so he's a creditor. We have to pay 15,000 to him. He has to pay 10,000 to us. We have to pay, as a business, we have to pay 15,000 to him. So we can set off the amount of 10,000. So when you set it off, the debtor value also will go down, creditor amount also will go down. So remember, if you get the entry cost set off entry, that will affect both control accounts, whereas the debtor control as well as the creditor control. So debtor's control, it's on the credit side because the value of debtor will come down. Set off entry 2,500. At the same time, in the creditor control also on the debit side, because your liability decreases. Set off entry, you have to enter into the debtor control as well as creditor's control, opposite side. So debtor's control credit, creditor's control debit. 2,500. Then you are balancing and get the carried down brought forward. Now, when I explained this question, I said it to you all. Always your debtors list equals to your debtors control account if you have done all these entries perfectly. But there can be some errors which you have not entered into the debtors ledger. There are some errors which you have not entered into the control account. So in that situation, there will be a difference in your list balance and the control account balance. These two balances won't be the same. If these two balances are not the same, we have to reconcile it. That is why we have to make a debtor's reconciliation and creditor's reconciliation. Why are we making the reconciliation? Because your list balance is one amount and your control account balance is another amount. Two different values are there. So in that situation, we have to reconcile it and we have to do the question. Now here, when you are doing the reconciliation, you all have to remember this part. When you read transaction by transaction, now here in this question, can you see here they have given 1 to 7 reasons. These are the reasons for the difference. So when you're looking at this entry by entry, now here they have given purchase journal was overcast by 6,000. Now when you go through these 7 entries, first you have to identify where is the error. Whether the error is in your control account or in the individual account. That part you have to identify first. Now, when you're looking at the purchase journal was overcast by 6,000, the error is in the total value. When you added up the total, the amount has been overstated by 6,000. So the error is in the total amount. Now, when you take the second entry, discount received of 3,200 was not entered in the creditors list. Creditors list we are getting from the creditors ledger. So creditors ledger means individual accounts. So the second reason, second error, you have got it from the individual account. In the individual account, you have not entered this 3,200. Now when it comes to the third one, a debit note of 3,000. For which prime entry book we are using a debit note? For purchase return journal. So you got a debit note of 3,000. First, you have to put it into the primary book, which is your purchase return journal, was completely omitted. That entry is not there at all. So here, the effect will be for both places. What do you mean by both? The error is in the control account as well as the list. So in that situation, when you are correcting, you have to correct both places. Number four, cash paid to creditors 1,500 had been correctly entered in the cash control account, but recorded in the personal account as 5,100. Again, they have given the word personal account. So the error is with the individual amount. Like that, you have to identify these errors, whether it will affect the total amount or the individual. So here, if there is any error with the total value, do the correction in the adjusted control account. So if there's an error with the total value, you have to do the correction in the adjusted control account. If there is any error with the individual value, do the correction in the reconciliation statement. So when you are doing the reconciliation, debtors reconciliation, creditors reconciliation, this part you have to identify properly. If there is any error with the total value, do the correction in the adjusted control account. If there is any error with the individual value, do the correction in the reconciliation statement. Now here, according to this question number one, creditors ledger control account balance was 56,000 and the creditors list balance, they have given 43,600, two different values. They are asking you to prepare adjusted creditors control account and creditors reconciliation statement. So here, for the adjusted creditors control, we have to open up a T account. For the reconciliation statement, we are going to open up a two column statement. Two columns to the right. Now, when it comes to this question, creditors ledger control account balance, they have given 56,000. That is your BEF value, 56. 56,000. Now, if you started the control account with this 56,000, you have to ended up with the reconciliation with 43,600. 43,600. Now, here, remember, here we have opened up adjusted creditors control account. When it comes to reconciliation statement, I have started with balance as per adjusted creditors control account. Balance as per creditors control account. That format, you had ended up with balance as per creditors list. Now, in this question, they have given the control account balance and the list balance. When you do all these corrections, you have to end up with this amount. So let's go one by one entry. One more thing you all have to remember. Now, if you have started this creditors reconciliation statement with the adjusted creditors control account, just think of this entry. Now, I told you if there is any error in the total, you have to put it into the adjusted control account. If there is any error in the individual, we have to put it into the reconciliation statement. When you are doing the reconciliation statement, you have to remember this part. Now here I have given a T account for the creditors, individual creditor account. Okay, so here you can see add and deduct in the reconciliation statement. Now I'm going to tell you how you are getting this add or deduct value. Okay. Normally in the creditors account, BEF comes to the credit side because it's a liability account. So if you enter any entry to the credit side, you are going to add this amount to the balance. So if you enter some entries to the credit side, your balance will increase. You are going to add it to the balance. If you enter some entries to the debit side, your value will go down. From the opening balance, you are deducting. For example, if you put the purchases amount, you are putting purchases to the credit side. So that amount you are adding to the opening balance. But if you put cash paid amount to the debit side, you are going to deduct it. So that's what I have given you here, minus plus. But remember, whenever you are starting with the adjusted control account, think of the opposite way. What do you mean by opposite way? Whatever the entry you are going to put it onto the credit side, minus it, deduct it. If you put any entry to the debit side, add it. So that is what you mean by add and deduct. Now, in the next sum, I'll show you this entry for you all to get it. Understand. If you start this reconciliation statement with balance as per creditors list, you have to do the normal way. Normal way means on the credit side, if you enter some entry, you are going to add it. If you put a debit entry, you are going to deduct. Since I have started the reconciliation statement with balance as per adjusted, do the opposite way. So if whenever you get a sum like this, just open up a small T account and do this one. Then it's easy for you to understand. Let's go to the question, then you will understand it better. Purchase journal was overcast by 6,000. That means the error is in the total amount. When you added up the journal, you have entered more 6,000. So more 6,000 means from the general, from the purchase journal, we are taking the double entry, purchasers debit, creditor control credit. But here the amount is more by 6,000. To correct it, what you are going to do? You have to remove it. In your adjusted creditor control, you are putting 6,000 as overstated purchases. For your reference, I have put the numbers here 1 to 7, so you can identify it easily. Normally, the double entries purchasers debit, creditor control credit, but according to this error, they say it has been overstated by 6,000. If it is overstated, remove that entry in the adjusted creditor control account. That's the number one. Discount received of 3,200. Discount received of 3,200 was not entered in the creditors list. When they say the word creditors list, that affect your individual value. So when you think of the double entry, discount received account credit, creditor account debit. Now, if I go to this small T account, this is the individual creditor account. Okay, so the discount received double entry is discount received credit, creditor account debit. The amount is 3,200. That amount was not there, so you have to enter it. If you enter this 3,200 on the debit side, according to this one, what you have to do? Add it. So under reconciliation, in your reconciliation under add, we are writing discount received 3,200. Discount received 3,200. Next, a debit note of 3,000 was completely omitted. Debit note is for purchase return. So completely omitted means you haven't entered anywhere. So purchase return credit, creditors debit. So this purchase return entry, you haven't entered at all. So that means purchase return account credit, creditor control debit. So we had to put this 3,000 to the adjusted creditors control account on the debit side, 3,000. At the same time, it is not included in the individual account as well. If I go to the individual account, purchase return double entry is purchase return credit, creditors account debit. So that 3,000 also we are entering to the debit side of the account. Debit side of the account means you have to add it. So that's why under add purchase return 3,000 is there. I have put number 3 both places. This is the third entry. So that entry you have to enter into both formats, adjusted as well as reconciliation. Cash paid to creditors 1,500 had been correctly entered in the cash control account, but recorded in the personal account as 5,100. Again, this error is in the individual. The amount paid is 1,005, but in the personal account, they have recorded 5,100. If we go to the individual account, cash paid to creditor, the double entry is cash credit, creditor account debit. I'll put a cross here. Creditor account debit. The amount is 1,500. But mistakenly, they have entered 5,100. They have entered 5,100. So here we have entered more. So the excess amount, by keeping 1,005, the excess amount, we have to remove it. When we remove it, that excess amount, we have to deduct it in the reconciliation. So this is the excess amount. 5,100 minus 1,005. When you pay cash to creditor, it's cash credit, creditor account debit. So the value comes the debit side. But instead of 1,005, they have entered 5,100. So the amount you have entered extra, you have to take it out. Take it out means you have to deduct. So under deduct, we are writing cash paid, number 4, fourth entry, 3,600. A set off balance of 5,000 had not been entered in the control account. Set off entry. Since we are making the creditor's control account here, in your adjusted creditor control, this amount you have to enter it. Which side? On the debit side. Because their creditor value will go down. As set off entry, 5,000. One of the creditors' balance, 4,000, had not been included in the list. One of the creditors' balance, so you should know, normally creditor balance is credit. That entry is not there. So if you enter it, you are entering onto the credit side. Onto the credit. So what is the sign here? Minus it. So under deduct, we are writing balance 4,000. Purchase return journal. Again, they are talking about the total amount was overstated by 3,000. So this is the error with the total. So you adjust it in your control account. Purchase return account credit, creditor control debit, but it has been overstated. So you have to remove it. In your adjusted control, you are going to remove it. Overstated purchase return, 3,000. So after entering everything, when you balance this account, carried down, brought forward, you will get 45,000. That 45,000 is the amount we are taking to the reconciliation. Why? We have started with adjusted creditor control account balance. 45,000 add, deduct, you will end up with the amount that they have given in the question. Question number two. The total balance in the list extracted from Amila's debtor's ledger as at 31st 12 2020 was 125,100. The debtor's control account had a different balance. Now in this question, they have not given you both balances just like the previous. Now in the previous sum, they gave you control account balance and the list balance both. But in the second question, they have given only the list balance. They have given only the list balance. That is why they have asked us to prepare the reconciliation statement first, then the adjusted control account. So when I open up a reconciliation, I have to start with balance as per debtors list. Why? In the question, they have given list balance only. So the value is 125,100. Now, since you have started with the list balance, this add and deduct, it's easy for you to think. Whenever you, in the debtor account, the BF is to the debit. Whenever you enter some entry to the debit, you are adding. If you put it onto the credit side, you are going to deduct it. So this is the thing that you have to take into consideration when you are doing this sum, because you have started the reconciliation statement with the list balance. So according to this one, add means in the individual account, if you want to put it some entry to the debit, you have to add it. If you want to put it onto the credit side, you have to deduct it. Now let's go one by one entry. Sarath's balance of 2,500, they have specifically given it's on the credit side, had been omitted from the list of debtors. Sarath's balance of 2,500, it's an individual, Sarath's balance. You have not entered in the list, so the error is with the individual. They have said credit balance, so when you enter onto the credit side 2,500, what is the sign here? What is the sign here? Minus this one. So in the reconciliation, we are writing under deduct Sarath's balance 2,500. Kasun's debt of 500 was written off as bad debt, but entered only in the debtor's ledger. Only in the debtor's ledger, that means you have entered in the individual account. Where you haven't entered? In the control. So in the adjusted control account, we are writing on the credit side because the double entry for bad debt is bad debt debit, control credit. We are writing bad debts 500. $1,500 in cash received from Lal had been debited to his personal account by error. So if I go to individual account, what they say, received $1,500 from Lal had been debited. When you receive money, it's cash debit, Lal's account credit. So I'll put a cross here, Lal's account. This is the proper entry. This side, but what they have done had been debited to his personal account by error. So they have entered 1,005 here. That is the error. So to correct it, what you have to do? When you put 1,500 to the credit side, it will cut it off. So you have to enter 3,000. You have to double the value. Double the value, what's the sign? Deduct. So under deduct, we are writing Lal 3000. Lal 3000. Salia's check for 6000 had been dishonored but not posted to the control account. However, this was correctly recorded in the personal account. Salia's check. You got a check from Salia and it got dishonored. So what's it? Which side you have to enter? When you got a check, cash debit, debtor control credit, if it got dishonored, you have to put it onto the debit side. Dishonored check 6000. Total of the sales journal 38,000 had not been posted to the relevant accounts in the general ledger, but correctly recorded in the debtor's ledger. In the general ledger means control account. So this total of 38,000, you have not entered in the control. The double entry is sales credit, debtor's control debit. So since it's a error in the with the total, you have to put it in the adjusted. 38,000. Now in this question, when you balance this, now there are no entries for add. When you do this simplification, you get the balance as per adjusted debtor's control account. So remember, this amount is the adjusted debtor's control value. So that is in your adjusted control, this is the closing BF. This is the closing BF. So BF to the debit, since it's a debtor account, CD to the credit 119,600. Then only we are balancing and getting this opening balance. Because in this question, they didn't give us a control account balance. Opening balance. From the reconciliation, we are taking the adjusted control account balance, enter it as a BF to the debit after the double line, take that amount to the CD, then balance it, go from bottom to top, missing figure is opening BF, opening balance. Opening balance. Question number 3. Balance of debtors ledger control account and creditors ledger control account as at 31st 12 2020 were 65,000 and 76,000 respectively. Whereas list of debtors ledger and creditors ledger were 70,000 and 80,000 respectively. Here they are asking you to prepare all four. Adjusted debtors control, debtors reconciliation statement, adjusted creditors control and creditors reconciliation statement. Now the given balances, let's enter it to accounts. In your adjusted debtors control, BF amount is 65,000. 65,000. And the list balance, they have given 70,000. Now remember, in this sum, I have started the reconciliation with adjusted debtors control. So I'm thinking of individual this part. Whenever entries come to the credit side, you have to add it. Debit side, deduct it. Again, adjusted creditors control opening balance. And again, I have started the creditors reconciliations with the adjusted. So I'm using this part. In the individual creditor account, if you put some entry to the debit side, add it. If you put the entries to the credit side, deduct it. Now, after this, let's go one by one entry. Sales journal. Again, the error is with the total. Overstated by 6,000. So you have to adjust it in your adjusted control. Sales journal. The double entry is sales credit, debtors debit. But it has been overstated. So you have to remove it. Here I have put number one. Overstated sales 6,000. Total of purchase journal 12,700 had been entered in the creditor's ledger control account as 17,200. Again, in the control account, you have entered more, overstated. So normal double entries, purchase debit, creditor control credit, but you have entered more. So remove it, take it to the debit side. Overstated purchases, this is the second entry. 4,500. A receipt of cash 8,000 from a debtor has not been posted to the debtor's ledger. Debtor's ledger is the individual. So when you receive money, I'll go here. Cash, debit, debtor account, credit side. So what you have to do? Add it in the reconciliation. Add it in the reconciliation, 8,000, the third entry. Third entry. Discount received of 5,000 has been posted to credit side of creditor's account in the creditor's ledger. The error is in the individual. What they say, discount receive. What's the double entry? Discount receive. Credit, creditor account, debit. Creditor account, debit. This is the double entry. I'll put a cross here. Discount received credit, creditor control, debit. But what they have done has been posted to the credit side of the creditor creditor's account. They have entered 5,000 to this side. 5,000 to this side. So to correct this error, what you are going to do? Take this 5,000 out. When you took it out, the entry will be cancelled. So you have to double the value and enter it on this side. To double the value, you have to put 10,000 to this side. So what's the sign? Plus sign. You are going to the reconciliation, creditors reconciliation. Under add, we are writing discount received 10,000. Discount received 10,000. Total of the sales return journal. Again, they are talking about the total. 2,700 has been posted to the debtor's ledger control account as 7,200. Sales return, double entry is sales return debit, debtor control credit. But here they have entered more. So the difference, you have to take it out. The difference, you have to put it onto the debit side of the adjusted debtor's control account. Overstated sales return, 4,500. Closing debit balance of 2,500 of a debtor has been posted as a credit balance. So the error is in the individual. In the debtor account, the closing balance of 2,500. So I'll put a cross here. But you have entered onto the credit side. Credit side, you have entered 2,500. So to correct this error, you have to double the value and enter it onto the debit side. you have to double the value and enter it onto the debit side. When you double the value, the amount is 5,000. Sign is deduct. Under deduct, we are writing 5,000. This is a sixth entry. This is the sixth entry. Purchase return journal has been overstated by 3,500. The error is with the total. Purchase return, the double entry is purchase return credit, creditors control debit. But creditor control, you have entered more. So remove it. In your adjusted creditors control, we are writing on the credit side, overstated purchase return 3,500. Bad debts of 3,500 has not been posted to the debtor's account. It's individual. So if I go to the small t account, the double entry for bad debt is bad debt debit, debtor account credit. So debtor account credit means you have to add it back. In the reconciliation statement, you are writing 3,500 under add. Ninth, opening credit balance of 4,000 has not been posted to the creditor's ledger. Opening credit balance. The balance is comes to here. When you put 4,000 to here, in your reconciliation statement, what you have to do? Deduct it. Deduct it. So when you simplify this debtors control, adjusted debtors control, you get the BF. That is the BF you are taking to the reconciliation first line. Then when you simplify, the amount that they have given in the question will be there. Here also the same. When you balance your adjusted creditors control, you get the carried down brought forward. This 75,000 we are taking to the reconciliation statement. Ultimately, when you balance it, you get the amount that they have given in the question. There's another question, you all can try it. In this question, again, they have given to both balances to you all, control account and the list balance. Just try it. I have given the answer as well. So when you go one by one here, no entry has been made in the control account. So where are you to do the adjustment? In the adjusted control account. The sales return journal has been undercast by 25,000. Again, return journal. Total, you have to do the adjustment in your adjusted debtors control. A debit balance of 21,500 and a credit balance of 3,500 had been omitted from the list. The individual error, you have to correct it in the reconciliation statement. A list of balances had been overcast by 2005. Again, list. You have to do the adjustment in the reconciliation. A debit balance of 3,500 in the debtor's ledger has been listed as a credit balance. Again, debtor's ledger, individual. Do the adjustment in the reconciliation. Set off entry of 10,250 had not been entered in the control account. So they have given it, you have not entered in the control. So do the adjustment in the control account. Goods returned by R. Silva costing 3,400 had been entered correctly in the control account. They have done it, the proper entry in the control account. But no entry had been made in R. Silva's account. So where is the error? In the individual. So to do the correction, you have to do the adjustment in the reconciliation. A check given by a debtor for 1,500 had been returned by the bank. Entries have been made in both bank account and the debtor's account, but no entry had been made in the control account. So it's a dishonored check. You have to put it in the control account. Which side? Debit side. This is the answer. So if you like this video, please subscribe. At the same time, click the like button. So here, when you balance your adjusted debtors control, you will get a carried down and brought forward of 87. That is the amount we are taking to the reconciliation. When you simplify this sum, you have to get the amount that they have given in the question. Thank you for watching this video.